back to Britney Unplugged, and as you can tell by the title of this video, we're going to be talking about the 5 types of people you should avoid. So if you want to know the 5 types of people you should avoid in any circumstance possible, and you want to spare yourself the stress, the trauma, the pain, and the hurt of dealing with these types of people, then keep watching. Now, the first type of person to avoid is the love bomber. Now, love bombing is lavishing someone with attention or affection in order to manipulate them or influence them into doing something. Now, if you meet someone for the first time, and maybe upon your first week of knowing them, they treat you as if you've known each other for years. Of course, you meet someone firsthand and you guys can click and you can talk as if you've known each other for years. But if they start showing you an immense amount of love and affection, the kind of affection that you may feel is undeserved because you guys haven't gotten to know each other that well, and they bomb you with so much love and they give you so much attention and they give so much care, and they're so quick to give you their undivided attention in that manner, and they behave as if you guys have known each other for a very long time and you've like had time to build that bond, then that's love bombing, and that's a very, very dangerous sign, and that's someone that you really need to avoid. Now, as humans, we're designed to really like it when someone gives us attention, when they give us care, when they give us love, when they give us loyalty, all of those great things. So when we see someone firsthand who gives us all of those things, then automatically we feel mentally inclined to give all of ourselves to them, to be vulnerable with them very quickly, to tell them our deepest, darkest secrets because you feel like that you can trust them. But with love bombers, since they're so quick to get to know you because of how manipulative they are and the attention that they give, it's very quick for them to analyze your strengths, your weaknesses, and the things that you enjoy and the things that you dislike, literally every single detail about you. And then if there comes a circumstance where you guys fall out, they're going to use that against you, and they'll really use your words against you in that manner. Now, one thing you need to remember about love bombers is that the same attention that they were so quick to give you, the same love that they're so quick to give you, and the same loyalty that they were so quick to give you is the same amount of time that they can turn on you just like that. Now, one thing you need to remember is that in a true relationship, a friendship with someone, love, loyalty, honesty, trust is something, those are the values that are built over time in the relationship. You need to get to know the person. If you meet someone firsthand and you find that they're bombing you with all of these qualities and they're making you feel like the most special person in the world without actually getting to know you, then that's a sign you need to look out for, because they're so quick to give you all of the good qualities that you end up missing out on all of the negativity that may come in that relationship because they want to mask it by love bombing you. And then they're going to end up manipulating you later on, and then you're going to be surprised that this is who they really are when their mask falls off. So if you find that you meet someone firsthand and they're like, oh my gosh, you're the best person ever, oh my gosh, I love you, you're like my best friend, even though you guys don't really know each other that well, instead of focusing on the great things that they're saying to you, really take time to analyze and say, am I really deserving of this attention that they're giving me now? Because of course we all deserve love, we all deserve attention, but then it depends on who the love and attention is coming from. So if you find that this person you've literally known for 5 minutes is already saying all of these things like, oh, you're my best friend, you're the best person ever, all of those things that you may want to hear from someone who you've known for a long time, then that's a high chance that the person is love bombing you, and you need to back away from that person ASAP. Now, the second category of people that you need to avoid are the wallowers, aka those who only know how to be the victim. Now, these are people who continue to let their problems define them, and then they drag you down with their problems, and they end up sucking the life out of the relationship that you have with them. Now, this person provides more problems than solutions. Now, of course, all of us go through very sad, traumatic, horrific experiences that can really bring us to a very dark place in our lives. But at the end of the day, it is up to us to bring ourselves out of that dark place, because other people around us can tell us to really get better and everything. But then if we don't think ourselves that it's time for us to get better, it's never gonna happen, because you don't believe that you actually can do it. But these types of people continue to live in their pity. They continue to live in their misery. Even if you give them advice, they'll probably do the opposite and continue to stay sad. You could be the best person possible to tell them that, look, you need to get it, you need to be happy, you need to find yourself again. But then they will choose to live in their sadness, and they drag you down with them. Now, you can be dragged down with them in the sense that maybe you could be their punching bag. So if they're going through something, then you are the person that they project their anger on. Maybe they keep on coming to you for advice, and then you keep giving them the most positive advice possible, but they don't follow it, and then they bring you down to where they are. Now, one thing about the category of the wallowers is that life will continue to pass them by, but they won't move with life because they continue to stay in a place that is preventing them from being the best version of themselves. But if you continue to associate yourself with one, and you continue to invest so much of your energy with a wallower in particular, then you'll realize that life will also pass you by because you're so focused on staying on a level where they are. Now, one thing you need to remember is that in a close friendship with someone or in a relationship, it's an automatic energy exchange. So if you're close with the person and there's a connection with the person, if they're upset, they're going to end up affecting your mood and you may end up feeling upset and vice versa. So you need to always think about that energy exchange and always be very cautious about who you're exchanging energy with, because you need to make sure that the person whose energy you are exchanging with is giving you good vibes and they're not really bringing you down to where they are. Now, the third category of people that you need to avoid, that you must always avoid, that by all means, if they come your way, please repel and go the other direction. Repel always. And these are the drama magnets. Now, the name in itself already gives away what these types of people are about. It really shows what they represent. Even if they may not even realize what they're representing, that is exactly what they represent. They are magnets for drama. Literally, drama is their best friend. Their life revolves around their explicit opinions of other people, what other people think of them, what's the latest gossip, what happened to her, what happened to him, what did he do, what did she do, why did she do this, why did she do that. It's literally about what the other person is doing and what the other person got involved with, and then it ends up involving them in that situation as well, because either they're talking about it or either they were in it, or it's just a number of things that cause them to just be involved in a whole mess and a big lump of drama. That's really what it is. Now, this type of person is probably the most dangerous person that you can associate yourself with, because one thing you need to remember is the people you surround yourself with are a reflection of who you are. Even if deep down you're not that person, but if people know you to associate with this type of person, they'll automatically put you and categorize you in the kind of personality that that person has. So if you're associated with someone who gets involved in a lot of drama, and it will actually have to take someone to have a one-on-one conversation with you for them to realize that maybe you aren't all about drama, but it's because of who you associate yourself with. But 99% of the time, people will run away from you because they know what you associate yourself with. So they'll miss out on the opportunity to get to know the real you because they've already put you into a category of someone who always gets involved in drama because of who you surround yourself with. So yes, it is important to make a name for yourself. It is so important by all means to make sure that you create a good reputation for yourself. But part of your good reputation is about who you surround yourself with. If you surround yourself with people who are not serious about their life, people will put you into that category and automatically your energies will match if you continue to put yourself in that position. If you surround yourself with people that have winning mindsets, successful mindsets, who have big hopes, dreams, and aspirations, then it will fuel you to be better and then you end up developing that mindset. If you chill with people that are always involved in a story, that are always talking about this person, gossiping about this person, then automatically you get dragged into that and you subconsciously do that, and then by the time you get so used to doing it, you become more damaged. Then it becomes something that's ingrained in you to always talk about this person, to always know what's happening with the other person, that you actually forget what's going on in your life because you're so concerned. So if you find that you're encountering someone who really doesn't care about what's going on in their life and they care more about what's going on in other people's lives and they care about talking bad about other people and just being involved in petty situations, then you need to avoid that person and stay far away before it affects your character and the way other people see you. Now, the fourth category of people that you really need to avoid are the excessively needy people. Now, these are people that demand for care and attention. And like I said, as humans, we all want attention. We all want someone to care for us. We want someone to really look out for us. We want to know that there's always going to be someone that we can count on. But then the moment it becomes excessive, then this needy person creates false and unrealistic realities in their head. For example, let's say if you're really busy with something, with school, for example, and then this person wants you to do something for them, but you tell them that, look, I'm not available right now. Can I get back to you later on? But then they're like, no, how can you do this? I need you right now. Why you're never there for me and all those things. That's them being needy, even though the reason why it's unrealistic is that they're coming to you at a time that is inconvenient for you, even though you have communicated that right now is not the best time for me to help you. Can I help you later on? You come up with an alternative, yes, but the fact that you can't help that person there and then means that it's a problem for them. So as a result, they end up getting really upset with you, even though they may understand that, okay, maybe it's not convenient for you, but the fact that you haven't helped them there and then, it becomes a problem. And that is the sign of a needy person. Now, the funny thing is, the one thing about excessively needy people is that they may ask you to do one thing for them. They may expect so much from you, But 99% of the time, they won't be there for you the way you have been there for them, because they expect you to do something for them when they don't think about what they have to do in return. So with needy people, they expect you to be a source of comfort and support for them, but they can't be the same to you. And that's also very toxic as well, because you end up wasting your energy trying to be there for someone who cannot reciprocate that, because you may end up getting accustomed to them always needing something from you. So when you need something and they're not there for you emotionally, they don't support you emotionally or even physically or whatever, then you end up getting more hurt, because you're like, I am putting so much energy into being there for you. I give you whatever you need. I try my best to be there for you. But then now that I need you, you're failing to reciprocate that. And then that can have a huge effect on you. So if you encounter someone that is needy in that regard, then you need to, by all means, avoid them. So in other words, a relationship with a needy person is very transactional, but it's not transactional on both sides. It's more transactional on their end, because they're taking something but they can't give it to you. Now the fifth and the final category of people that you need to avoid at all costs, and this is probably the biggest giveaway, the biggest sign of all, and these are jealous people. Now, with jealous people, their envy towards you is almost as if it's ingrained in their blood system. It's like the envy they have for you literally flows through them. And then even when they win, as long as their win isn't bigger than yours, they're not going to be happy with that. Even if you're happy for their win, let's say you're above them and then they win something, but then they don't really reach your level, for example. But then you support them and you cheer them on because you're generally a good person, but you don't know that they're jealous of you. So you support them and everything. They don't like the fact that you're supporting them because they're not on the level that you are, or they're not higher than where you are. So just because they won something and they're below you does not mean that they're satisfied, because as long as they're below you, they're never going to be happy. So with jealous people, you need to avoid them, because they're literally acting based on envy. Every single win is to do better than you. And of course, you may not realize there and then that someone is jealous of you, but just pay attention to how they react when you win something. Pay attention to how they act when you're upset, because a lot of the time they'll be there for you when you're upset because you're not doing as well as they are. But then as soon as you win, they may not be happy at all. So just be very mindful. And you know, every person is different, and you'll know and you'll be able to tell, you know, in different circumstances when someone is either displaying traits of an envious nature, and that's how you'll know whether or not to avoid them. But by all means, avoid someone who is jealous of you and who doesn't want to win with you. Please avoid them by all means. So these are the types of people that you need to avoid, and I'm pretty sure you'll do a lot better if you avoid these people as well. Thank you so much for watching, guys. As always, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share, and hit the bell to be notified when I post new videos. Stay safe, everyone. God bless you all. Bye.